The morning was cloudy and it was about to rain at any minute. So that morning was very cloudy, so it was going to rain any minute. The barber had a new hat which he did not want to spoil in the rain. So to protect his hat from the rain, he had worn the brass basin upside down upon his head. So he wore it like a helmet. This brass basin was worn by him like a helmet, so to protect his hat from the rain. It covered this hat and, being clean, glittered at more than a mile's distance. So at such a long distance also, because this basin was very clean, kept clean, it glittered, it shone at a very long distance. But Don Quixote had read so much about Mambrino's helmet that he could think of nothing else. So his mind was full of Mambrino's, the stories that he read, that he could not think else but only about the Mambrino's enchanted helmet. If he wanted to find a golden helmet, his mind could turn anything he wished into one. So if he wanted to find a golden helmet, his mind would imagine different things and wish to get one like that. When Don Quixote saw the poor knight come nearer, he raised his lance, which was only the branch of a tree. Lance is a long spear, like you can see in this picture, this soldier or the knight is keeping in his hand. In the picture you can see, it is made of metal, but our Don Quixote has got a lance which is just a branch of a tree. It's a stick. Without any warning whatsoever, he charged at his mare towards the startled man. So he's on his horse. When he saw this man, the barber was so startled, surprised to see him charging at him. As he galloped close, he pointed the lance at him. So he kept the lance at him and determined, showed that he is going to stab him, he is going to kill him, and shouted, "Wretch." Wretch here means an unfortunate person, because he is going to lose everything. He is going to take away the helmet or the brass basin from him. So that's why he is calling you unfortunate or a wretch. Save yourself, or at once surrender the helmet. You either save yourself and surrender the helmet, because that is for me, that is justly mine, it is mine, you give it to me. The barber, seeing a wild-eyed old man charging at him on a horse, had just enough time to throw himself from his donkey. So when this barber saw him, this wild-eyed, angry-eyed old man charging at him, he didn't even have the time to think. He just threw himself down from his donkey and took to his heels. Means he ran away from that place. How did he run? He leaped over the hedge. He jumped over the hedge and at the side of the road, which was at the side of these hedges, were at the side of the road, and ran away across the fields. And he ran into the fields and away, ran away across the fields as swiftly as a deer, as quickly, as fast as a deer, because they run very fast. But the brass basin, having slipped from his hand was left lying in the dust. So when he was jumping, his helmet fell down. That brass basin which he was wearing to protect his head from the rain fell down on the ground in the dust. Don Quixote stopped his mare. So now Don Quixote stopped his mare. "Here, Sancho," he cried. He called, he shouted at Sancho, said, "Here, see, here is my helmet. Now I found my helmet. Come and pick it up for me." So he calls him to pick the helmet for him. "Upon my word, that is a fine basin. It is just an utensil, it's just a basin," said Sancho. "Believe me, master, it is not a helmet, it's just a basin, utensil," as he handed it to his master. He picked it up and gave it to his master. Don Quixote, with great delight, clapped it on his head. So now he was very happy and he tried to clap it. He tried to adjust it on his head. He turned it this way and that and tilted it backward and forward, moved it forward and backward. "It is pretty large," then he said. The size of the brass basin was large. The head for which it was made must have been a big one. So he is saying that this helmet which was made for the knight was bigger than his. "Sadly, it has no visor." Here, that helmet has a shield, a protected or in front of it covers your the mouth and the front part except the eye. It has got an attachment to it. And half of one side is missing. That part was missing in that helmet. Because it was not a helmet actually. It was just a basin. That is why. But he didn't want to believe. He was just in his own the influence of the books he read, that he wants to think only. He was relating everything to the enchanted helmet. Sancho tried to hide his laughter. So when he was saying all these things, Sancho could not stop his laughter, and he was trying to hide his laughter, because if he laughs in front of him, he is going to get very angry. "What are you grinning at now?" He asked him, "Why are you laughing at?" cried his master angrily. Now he saw him laughing, so he got very angry and he said, "Why are you laughing?" "Oh, nothing," answered Sancho. No, master, nothing. I'm not laughing. I was only thinking what a big fool the man must have been to wear a helmet that looks so much like a barber's basin. So I was just wondering that what a big fool that person who must have worn this helmet that looks like a barber's basin. "Well, it does look like a barber's basin," said Don Quixote. So he said, yes, exactly, it looks like a barber's basin. "But that is because some enchanter has changed its form." So those people or the person who wore it has changed its form, has changed the look of it. "When we come to a town where there is an armorer is the person who makes these arms and all, okay, and he says, when we reach a town where we find this person, I will have it remade it in its proper shape. So I will make it properly done, for there is no doubt that it is really the helmet of the famous Mambrino." And now he completely believed that this helmet was the famous Mambrino's helmet. He turned it about on his head and pulled it well down over his ears. So now he tried to fix it. I will wear it as it is, he said. Now I will wear it as it is, the way I got it. It is better than not having a helmet. It is better to wear this helmet than to be bareheaded. There is that. There is that knight, silver grey horse, said Sancho, pointing to the barber's grey donkey, which was nibbling grass by the roadside. I think I will exchange my own faithful beast for him. So now Sancho's eyes saw the silver grey horse, which is not silver grey horse, but the donkey, barber's grey donkey, which was left because he left his horse, donkey, and ran into the fields. And it was nibbling, he was eating the grass by the roadside. I think I will exchange my own faithful beast for him. So he wanted to change his beast, that his animal, that is donkey, for this barber's donkey. He wanted to exchange it with that. Well, exchange is no robbery. So he is trying to tell, Don Quixote answered, sir, exchanging, we are not taking it away, we are just exchanging things. That is not called robbery. We do not rob those whom we meet, for that is not what a brave knight does. So he is trying to tell, justify himself, and he is saying, no, we are not robbing, we are not robbing anyone, it is not called robbery. Because we are just exchanging things. We are not taking anyone's thing. The horse is no doubt very dear to its master. It should be left for him. So he said, no, no, don't take the horse. Because it is very dear. Very fond. The master likes the likes his horse. So let's not take his horse. It should be left for him. We should leave it for him. But I give you leave, Sancho, to exchange saddle, the seat on the donkey, which he liked very much. So he said, you can exchange the saddle, but don't take the beast, or don't exchange the donkey. You are a wise master, said Sancho. So for this he said, you are a very nice master, Sancho, said Sancho. Without another word, he made his own poor donkey look three times better by dressing him in the barber's saddle. So quickly, he didn't want to waste time because he may change his mind. So he quickly took that barber's saddle from the donkey and put it on his donkey and made him look much better than the barber's donkey. Both having gained something from their adventure, the strangely dressed knight and his squire continued on their journey. So, at the end, their journey, in this journey, they earned something. They got something, and they were strangely dressed because he was wearing a brass basin as a helmet, and both of them continued on their journey. The story still continues. You can enjoy this complete story. You can get it issued from any library and enjoy reading the story. For this lesson, we are going to have only this much. So I would want you children to read the story at least 3 to 4 times and understand the story well. In my next video, we are going to do the reading comprehension exercises related to this lesson. That's all for now, children. Take care.